like in episode 5, we are covering all the heroes who were born between October 26 and November 1. So we have four such, two such.
Middle one is Sardar Patel.
Tell me, do you know anyone from this list?
Yeah, I know.
You can
the middle one is Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel.
Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel.
And anyone? Okay. Out of five pictures here, do you know anyone? Hello? No response.
I know Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel. He's in the middle.
Pandit, Mahika, Samar. At least, who is in the center?
Sardar
Vallabhbhai Patel.
Okay.
Now, can you hear me?
Okay.
Can you hear me?
So, the center one is clear to everyone. Okay. Who is in the center?
Can you hear me now?
So we'll come, okay, if you don't know, that's fine, okay. We are going to cover anyway these five stories today. So let's start one by one. Okay. The first story.
Nimesh Uncle, can you hear me?
Vidyarthi. So who was Ganesh Shankar Vidyarthi? So he was born in Allahabad, which is now renamed to Prayagraj, on 26 October 1890. Okay. So Ganesh was an avid reader. Okay, he read a lot of books since a young age. Okay, and since a childhood, he was interested in writing and journalism. So at the age of 16, he published his first book in Hindi with Hamari Atmuj Sargat. Okay, so that was his first book. At the age of 16, he published that book. Okay, and he was a brilliant writer, brilliant author, and brilliant reporter. So his name was Ganesh Shankar. The Vidyarthi was the pet name he adopted for his writings. Okay. Vidyarthi means student, seeker of a knowledge. Okay, seeker of knowledge. So that was his pet name. So he wrote all his books and articles under the name of Vidyarthi. That's why he is referred to as a Ganesh Shankar Vidyarthi. He started writing articles in the famous publication Saraswati under Pandit Mahavir Prasad Dwivedi. So that was a very famous publication in Uttar Pradesh that time. When there was a British rule, right? So Saraswati was the first publication where he started writing. Then he also got associated with the Abhyudaya, the Hindi political journal of Mahamana Madan Mohan Malviya. So Madan Mohan Malviya was another very famous name of that era. Okay, we'll talk about his story in December. So Ganesh Shankar was, since a young age, he was associated with these great personalities. Okay, Mahavir Prasad Dwivedi, Madan Mohan Malviya. So these personalities have shaped his career, basically shaped his and inspired him in his life. Then Vidyarthi started or founded a newspaper, a Hindi newspaper called Pratap. Yeah, Pratap was a very famous revolutionary newspaper, which was founded by Ganesh Shankar Vidyarthi. It was founded in 1913, November 1913 in Kanpur. And it was known for the revolutionary writings against the British. With his zealous writing, he worked to connect the revolutionary movement with the masses of that time. Okay, so he brought those revolutionary ideas to the masses through the medium of Pratap. Okay. For his writings against the British Empire, Vidyarthi was sent to jail 5 times. He was also imposed monetary fines, his press was shut down, a lot of things were done, but he continued fighting. He was associated with Bhagat Singh when Bhagat Singh came to Kanpur. He advised Bhagat Singh on multiple occasions. He was also inspired by Mahatma Gandhi, and he took active part in the non-cooperation movement launched by Gandhiji. Okay. He also successfully contested election of provincial legislative councils from Kanpur. When the elections were conducted at that time in Kanpur, he successfully contested and he was elected. Vidyarthi fought for the communal harmony, okay, throughout his life, okay, through his paper, through his writings, he always fought for the communal harmony, okay, to live in a peaceful environment and together fight against the British. Now, 1931, after the hanging of the Bhakti Sukhdeva Rajguru, there were initial protests, and the protests turned into riots in Kanpur. Yes. The riots ultimately turned communal. There was a communal riots against two communities. The Vidyarthi went out of his house to stop the riots. He saved a lot of people who were trapped in the riot areas. But one day he himself was caught by the rioters and he was in the riots. He was found 4 days after his death.
Ganesh Shankar Vidyarthi.
So that was the legacy of the Ganesh Shankar Vidyarthi. Now, in his honor, Government of India started Ganesh Shankar Vidyarthi Awards for the outstanding work in Hindi journalism and creative literature in 1989. Okay, which are very which are considered very prestigious awards in Hindi literature and journalism. So that is the story of Ganesh Shankar Vidyarthi. The second story we have is Jatin Nath Das, or Jatin Das, as he was called. Jatin
Das. I hear this name.
Suffix that is given to an elder brother in Bengali. So he was, naturally he was a Bengali. He was born on 27th October 1904 in Calcutta. There was a revolutionary organization in Bengal then called Anushilan Samiti. Anushilan Samiti conducted a lot of revolutionary activities in Kolkata, in Dhaka and other parts of Bengal that time. So Jatin Das became a member of it at a very young age. He also participated in the non-cooperation movement when it was launched in 1919. So he was very young at that time. He participated in that movement. At the age of 17, he was arrested for the first time and was sent to jail. In jail, he started hunger strike. Bhukh hatal chalu kiya. Because there was the British were not treating the prisoners well. They were not given good clothes. They were not given food. So he started hunger strike in jail. So after 20 days, the jail authorities apologized and the strike was ended. And he did all this at the age of 17. After that, Jatin Das learned to make bombs. Okay. He learned that art. Okay. And he was associated with HSRA, the Hindustan Socialist Republican Association, which was the organization. This organization where the Bhagat Singh, Sukhdev, Rajguru, Chandrasekhar Azad were working. Yes, Jatin Das also become part of that. And he taught them how to make bombs. He supplied them bombs. When Bhagat Singh and Batu Keshav Das threw the bombs in the Central Legislative Assembly in 1929, yeah, those bombs were made by Jatin Das. Okay. So after that act, Bhagat Singh was arrested, Batu Keshav Das was arrested, ultimately Sukhdev and Rajguru were arrested, and Jatin Das was also arrested after some time. All were kept in the Lahore jail with other revolutionaries. They were all together in the Lahore jail. In jail, Bhagat Singh started the hunger strike and Jatin Das also joined that. Everyone joined actually for the better treatment of prisoners and for food. The hunger strike, this hunger strike lasted a long time. It lasted for 63 days. The British tried everything. Yeah, they were beaten, they were force fed. उनके ऐसे नाक में नली डाल के दूध पिलाते थे, बहुत चीजें किया, लेकिन दे ब्रिटिश कुड नॉट सक्सेस. स्ट्राइक वेंट ऑन फॉर 63 डेज.
ओह माय गॉड.
इट गेन्ड अ लॉट ऑफ सपोर्ट अक्रॉस द इंडिया. एंटायर इंडिया केम आउट विद द सपोर्ट. फाइनली ब्रिटिश एग्रीड टू देयर डिमांड्स, बट अनफॉर्चुनेटली जतिन दास डाइड इन जेल बिकॉज ऑफ द स्ट्राइक आफ्टर 63 डेज. There were a lot of protests across India against his death, and he was brought from Lahore to Calcutta. The train stopped. There were many national leaders came out to support him, okay, including Jawaharlal Nehru. They also came out in support of Jatin Das. Okay. Ultimately, when he reached Calcutta, the procession was led by Subhash Chandra Bose in Calcutta. Subhash Chandra Bose called Jatin Das young Dadichi. Now who was Dadichi? Dadichi was a saint, okay, ancient saint in India, who sacrificed his own life for the gods, for the betterment of gods, okay, to give them weapons. So Subhash Chandra Bose ने जतिन दास को यंग दतीची बताया था, यंग इंडिया का दतीची, जिसने अपनी सेक्रीफाइस देके इंडिया के लिए अपना काम किया है. सो दैट वाज द रीजन ही वाज कॉल्ड यंग दतीची. सो दैट इज द स्टोरी ऑफ जतिन दास. नेक्स्ट स्टोरी वी हैव इज आचार्य नरेंद्र देव. Now Narendra Dev was born again in Uttar Pradesh in Sitapur on 30th October 1889. He was just 10 years old when he attended the Lucknow session of Congress with his father in 1899. Okay. And he got inspired by Bal Gangadhar Tilak, Bipin Chandra Pal, Arvindo Ghosh, who were the Congress leader at that time. He was very inspired by them and he decided to join the freedom movement. He was a very knowledgeable person. He was deeply influenced by the Russian Revolution or Russian Kranti, the 1917 mein hui thi. So he was very much influenced by that thing. So he believed in the socialism that was become a main driving force in Russian Revolution, and also inspired by the Gandhiji's non-violence. So he took part in the non-cooperation movements of that era, and he was arrested multiple times. In 1926. He became the vice chancellor of Kashi Vishwavidyapeeth. Yeah. So that was a big university in Kashi. He became vice chancellor of that. And that is how he came to be known as a Acharya. Acharya is the principal or the head of the university. So, and he was affectionately called Acharya Narendra Dev. He also became vice chancellor of Banaras Hindu University, which is BHU, and Lucknow University later on. Within Congress, he was a leader of the socialist section. Yeah. And he was inspiration for many future leaders, okay, including the Lok Nayak, Jayaprakash Narayan, and others who were inspired by his socialist ideas, who were very young. And Acharya Narendra Dev was kind of a guru to them. Yeah. During Quit India movement, he was arrested and kept in the same jail along with Jawaharlal Nehru at the Ahmednagar. Yeah. And he didn't have much, he died in 1956, so he didn't have much to do after the independence, but he is still remembered as one of the icons of the socialist movement in India. So that is the story of Acharya Narendra Dev. Now we have the story of a scientist. Yeah, Homi Jahangir Baba. Sunaya naam inka. Okay. He is one of the pioneer scientists of India. Okay. Humne Abdul Kalam ki story padhi. So Abdul Kalam ke guru the Vikram Sarabhai. Vikram Sarabhai ke saath aur unke colleague the Dr. Jahangir, Homi Jahangir Baba. Okay. So he was born on 30th October 1909 in a wealthy Parsi family of Bombay. He was Parsi in Mumbai, and he was related. Tatas are also Parsi, right? So G.R.D. Tata and Jamsetji Tata. The stories will be covered anyway. So he, the Baba family was related to Tata families. Homi Baba England to study engineering at Cambridge, but he soon realized that he was more interested in physics than engineering. Okay, so he subjects. He started learning nuclear physics. He ultimately received PhD in physics in 1935. And his topic of research was cosmic rays. And this was the era, the 1930s, was the era when a lot of development in nuclear science was being done after the Einstein's research, right? The nuclear bomb was in the trial stage. So there was a lot of focus on the nuclear energy. So Baba was also interested in that. He did a lot of research in that area. In 1936,
he
discovered electron positron scattering process, okay, which became famous as a Baba scattering. Okay, and that made him world famous. That was a very important discovery in the world of physics. Okay. So that made him world famous. I'm not going in detail of what is Baba scattering because that's an area of research, but this is something that made him famous throughout the world, and he was very young at that time. 1939, he returned to India once the World War II started. He started a research in Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore, okay, under the Dr. C.V. Raman. C.V. Raman was heading that institute that time. Then he managed to obtain grant from Sir Dolab Tata Trust and started cosmic rays research at IISc. So that was the first such a research institute within India. Research lab he started in IISc on the cosmic rays and nuclear energy. Then with the help of G.R.D. Tata, who was the Tata chairman at that time, he set up the Tata Institute of Fundamental Research, TIFR, in Mumbai. Initially, that institute was set up in the same house where Baba was born, in his own house, Homi Baba's house. Then it was later now, shifted to Bangalore. So right now that institute is in Bangalore, and it is a very good institute of India in the field of science. It is still there, TIFR. Dr. Homi Baba is known as the father of nuclear energy in India. So father of nuclear science program for India is Dr. Homi Baba. Okay. He had a very good rapport with the India's first Prime Minister, Jawaharlal Nehru. So after independence, on Prime Minister Nehru's advice, he led India's nuclear energy program. Okay. He established the Atomic Energy Establishment at Trombay, which is near Mumbai. Now after his death, it was renamed as a Baba Atomic Research Center, BARC, which is a very, the India's topmost atomic research organization. Okay, you might have heard about BARC because all the nuclear tests we have done, right? Pokhran and other things, the nuclear research is being done. Is everything is done at Baba, this BARC, the Baba Atomic Research Center. Baba also played a crucial role in the development of electronics in India. Remember, this was the early 1950s and 1960s, and he played a very crucial role in bringing the new electronics in India and development of electronics in India. He was not only an outstanding scientist, he was also a very good artist and a painter. His paintings are still there in the BARC and TIFR campuses. Yeah, when you visit these places, you see that this place also has his paintings. Okay. And he was elected a fellow of the Royal Society, which is the very honorable prize for the scientist in 1941. And in 1954, he was honored with the Padma Bhushan by Indian government. On 24th January 1966, he died in a plane crash. So unfortunately, he died early, but he laid the foundation of the atomic research in India.
He died in a?
So that I is the story of Homi Jahangir Baba.
Uncle, I didn't understand how he died in that last fight.
You can see here in the photo. And here you can see there is a Homi Baba at the center. There is a... And this is Neil Bohr. Neil Bohr is a very famous
scientist. He died in a plane crash.
You will learn about Neil Bohr. Okay. And Bohr's model in science, as you... Okay, probably in the, I think, 9th or 10th classes, you will come to... And Baba was in the same league as the scientist. The last story we have is, of course, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel. Okay. So he was born on 31st December 1875 in Nadiad, which is located in Gujarat, okay, near Ahmedabad. Now, Sardar Patel's father was also Zawedbhai Patel. Was also a freedom fighter. He also he participated in the war against the British under Rani Lakshmibai in 1857. And he was arrested, then later on released. So Sardar Patel belonged to that family, yeah, of the freedom fighters. Vallabhbhai was a brave and disciplined child. There are a lot of stories of his bravery during his childhood. Yeah. He worked in Gujarat for a few years after his initial education. Then he went to London in 1910 to become a barrister, which was very common that time. Gandhiji also went to London to become barrister. Jawaharlal Nehru also went there. Sardar Patel also similarly wanted to become a barrister and went to London. He became a barrister at the age of 36, which was like quite old, right? Because he came from a very poor background, okay? Decent family. So initially he worked hard to save enough money to go to London. And then he completed his course. He topped the course. Okay. And ultimately returned to India in 1913. After coming to India, he settled in Ahmedabad and became a successful barrister in Ahmedabad. He was one of the topmost lawyers of Ahmedabad High Court. And he was much sought after. And now, because he had money, he started having a very lavish lifestyle. He adopted the European clothes after coming back from London. And he had a club membership. He would spend his time there in the clubs playing cards and playing other games. He also became a sanitation commissioner of Ahmedabad and was active in Ahmedabad Municipal Corporation for many years. Actually, he in his biography he mentioned that those are the best years of his life. Okay, when those he spent in Ahmedabad. Now, what happened that in 1917, Gandhiji came to Ahmedabad to give a lecture, and Vallabhbhai Patel happened to attend that lecture, and then he was inspired by the vision of Mahatma Gandhi. And he decided to boycott the British clothes he was wearing, and he adopted khadi and jumped into the satyagraha movement. In next year, in 1918, he successfully led Kheda Satyagraha, okay, which was against the tax imposed on the poor peasants by the British. After the flood, British were hell-bent on collecting the tax, but the poor farmers were not able to give the tax. So it led to a satyagraha, which was led by Sardar Patel, become a huge success. After this Kheda Satyagraha, Patel became active leader in Congress, become a national leader. So across nation, people started recognizing his name. In 1928, Vallabhbhai became the leader of over 87,000 peasants or farmers of Bardoli district against the unjust revenue collection by the British. In Bardoli, again, there was a drought and British were helping on collecting the revenues. They asked for the 3 times more tax, but the farmers didn't have money. So 87,000 farmers of Bardoli district came out for the protest, and Sardar Patel became the leader. Okay, and this went on for many months. Okay, ultimately, British bowed down. Okay, they accepted the demands. Okay, so under the guidance of Patel, they continue the Andolan, and ultimately won. And because Sardar Patel so successfully led this Andolan, he was given the title of Sardar. Gandhiji called him the Sardar of people, and that's how he was came to be known as a Sardar Patel. Okay, so Bardoli Satyagraha was the one which gave him the title Sardar. Now, Sardar Patel had become very important leader of the Congress. He extended the party across the nation, and he was very disciplined. Okay, he brought much needed discipline in the party. Okay. Now, during Quit India movement, he was arrested like other leaders. And in 1945, he was released when it was almost certain that now British will leave India and India will gain the independence. But it was a very crucial phase because British were planning to divide India into multiple parts, and then the Patel played a very important role. We'll talk about that now. Now, on the request of Mahatma Gandhi, Sardar Patel declined the position of Congress president and accepted Pandit Nehru as the leader. And that's how Pandit Nehru became the first Prime Minister of India instead of Sardar Patel. By 1946, it was certain that partition will happen. Okay, India will be divided into 2 parts. But there was a possibility that entire Punjab, Assam, okay, and Bengal will become part of the Pakistan. Okay, so Sardar Patel worked tirelessly along with V.P. Menon to ensure that India retained these critical states. Okay, so the map that we see right now of India from Kashmir to Tamil Nadu and from Gujarat to Assam is largely thanks to the efforts of Sardar Patel and V.P. Menon. They managed to retain all the important states within India, including Assam, Arunachal Pradesh, Punjab, Bengal, and Kashmir. Yeah. There were more than 500 princely states, and British were planned to give. Okay, British had planned that India will have such small states within its territory. So within 18 months, okay, Sardar Patel ensured that all the states are integrated within India. This included all the small states, states from the Kathiawar, Jodhpur, Bikaner, Travancore, Mysore, the small big states. There's a lot of states within 18 months. All the states were integrated within India, and that's how the map of India formed. Three major states were integrated after the independence, which were the Junagadh, Hyderabad, and Kashmir. So it was the vision of Sardar Patel that united India. His stern and practical approach won him loyalty to the princes and kings. All the princes and kings were quite loyal to Sardar Patel. Yeah, Aditi, please say. What do you want?
I don't understand how he was the Iron Man.
You want to ask something?
I didn't understand how he is the Iron Man of India. Can you hear me?
Go ahead. Okay, we'll take, if you have a question, you can ask it on as well.
Uncle, can you hear me?
Sardar Patel was independent India's first deputy prime minister and home minister. And as a home minister, he converted the ICS, which was Indian Civil Services, which was under the British Raj. He converted that into IAS. Indian,
can you hear me?
Which laid the foundation of the civil services within India, which was very much
for
the administrative governance of the country. Right? We'll need those administrative officers to run the India, and Sardar Patel laid the foundation of that. And that is why he is also known as the father of modern All India Services. Sardar's uncompromising nature and firm resolve. He was very strict. Okay. And that's why he's also known as the Iron Man of India. He has got many names. He's also got the Bismarck of India. Okay. That is the story of Sardar Patel. Okay. Yes, Aditi?
Can you hear me?
I'm not able to hear you. Is it on the mic side? I'm not. Okay, somehow I'm not able to hear your voice. If you, okay. No, I cannot hear you, Aditi. You can type question as well in the chat. The story of Sardar Patel. Yeah. So I think we have covered all the things. And here, okay, some of the photos of Sardar Patel. All these four photos are of Sardar Patel. Okay, this is a young Sardar Patel. Okay. And this is him as a barrister. Okay. And then ultimately, this is the Sardar Patel that we know of as a Deputy Prime Minister of India or Home Minister of India. And here we have Sardar Patel with his brother, Vitthalbhai Patel. Vitthalbhai Patel was also an Indian freedom fighter. And his story will cover sometime. And both brothers had their own visions. So here in this picture, we can see both of them together. Yeah. Why he is called the Iron Man of India? Yes, so I mentioned that, but again, repeat that. One of the things that was stand out about Sardar Patel was,
I didn't understand why he's Iron Man of India.
He was very firm and decisive in his decision making. Yeah. So once Sardar Patel took any decision, or once he supported any idea, no one within Congress or outside Congress, there was hardly anyone who would challenge that thing. Because Sardar Patel will think of all the angles, and it is considered that once Sardar Patel said something, it is the final word. Okay. And that iron, because of that iron will, okay. That was the reason why he was managed to integrate all the 500 states within this short time, because he a lot of time used the persuasive measures. The some princes will not agree, will even threaten them, or he will guide them. Okay, as an elder brother or as a father figure, he will unko daante bhi the, acche se. And that is why he is called the Iron Man of India, because of his firm resolve. Okay, the iron ko kaise sabse strong material mana jata hai na? So he was the strong man of India.
Which of these two is, Sardar Patel?
Iron Man of India. Yeah. Why is called Sardar? We already know. Because Bardoli Satyagraha, he led the peace.
Second one is the Sardar Patel.
Successfully,
and there was the family. Which one?
More than 87,000 farmers.
Second, which one is? Second one.
There is some issue on my side. I am not able to hear your voices. Okay, so if possible, you can.
Seven.
You can use chat. So this is how. This is where we come to.
Now, can you hear me?
All the stories of this way. So now you know the these people, right? So this is Jatin Das or Jatindranath Das. This is Acharya Narendra Dev. We have Sardar Patel, Ganesh Shankar Vidyarthi, and Dr. Humi Baba. Remember this name, okay? Try to read about them. Okay, there are a lot of stories. This is like, I don't know if you can see, but okay, like there is a book. I have a book of Sardar Patel as well. And this is a very good book actually. Okay, and if you also have such books about others, okay, do share. Okay, and if you want to read this, you can take it from me. Yeah. So now the part is the fun quiz. Okay. Just write A, B, C, D in your answers, okay, in your chat. You can use chat to write A, B, C, D. So one will go with, Bardoli Satyagraha will go with what? A, B, C, D, or E? Hello? Any idea? किसके साथ एसोसिएट है बादोई सत्याग्रह किसके साथ जाएगा नरेंद्र देव के साथ होमी बाबा गणेश शंकर विद्यार्थि सरदार पटेल और जतिन दास यस करेक्ट आंसर इज डी गुड सरदार पटेल राइट सरदार द नेम द सरदार टाइटल वाज गिवन बिकॉज ऑफ बादोई सत्याग्रह सो सरदार पटेल द प्रताप हिंदी न्यूज़पेपर कौन थे वो जर्नलिस्ट जिन्होंने स्टार्ट किया था प्रताप
जतिन दा
सी सी इज द करेक्ट आंसर गणेश शंकर विद्यार्थी हु स्टार्टेड हंगर स्ट्राइक कौन थे जिन्होंने जेल में हंगर स्ट्राइक की थी ओके जिसके लिए पूरा इंडिया उनके सपोर्ट में आ गया था जो भगत सिंह के साथ थे जतिन दास यस ई जतिन दास यस आचार्य किसको बोलते थे ओके इनमें से Okay. Narendra Dev, Ganesh Shankar Vidyarthi, Sardar Patel, Jatin Das. Yes, of course.
Humi Baba.
Acharya Narendra Dev. Okay, because he was the Vice Chancellor of
Acharya Narendra.
Kashi Vidyapeeth and Banaras Hindu University. And who is the father of India's nuclear program? Isko bol.
Humi Baba.
Who is called the father of India's nuclear program? साइंटिस्ट कौन है इनमें से एक ही साइंटिस्ट है एक्चुअली नरेंद्र देव होमी बाबा गणेश शंकर विद्यार्थि सरदार पटेल जतिन दास यस बी राइट अदिति होमी बाबा यस गुड या सो महिका अदिति आल्सो मेंशन दैट ओके आप लोगों ने अमरचिता कथा पढ़ी है दैट्स अ वेरी गुड एक्चुअली अमरचिता गिव्स अ वेरी गुड इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट दिस पीपल वो काफी हाई लेवल पे बताता है विच इज अ वेरी गुड थिंग एक्चुअली सो Keep reading, okay? उनके बारे में ज्यादा पढ़ना चाहिए सो दिस इज एक्चुअली दिस आर द करेक्ट आंसर्स ए ओके सो वी हैव सो आई थिंक दिस इज वेयर वी कम टू द एंड ऑफ द सेशन कीप रीडिंग अमरचित्र कथा रीड करो और भी बुक्स हैं वो सही रीड करो ओके और आपको कोई भी क्वेश्चन हो कुछ भी हो आप उस ग्रुप पे बोल सकते हो या मुझे ऐसे फोन करके बता सकते हो आई विल टॉक थिंक आई थिंक टुडे
नाउ कैन यू हियर मी
हम स्टडी सेशन बाद में करेंगे But let's see next week. Consist stories. Next week also we have good stories. Okay, so hopefully we'll have time to cover all of them.
But
we'll try that.
Can you hear me now?
Audio proper chale aur aap also tell some stories.
Can you hear me?
Okay.
Hello, Ramya.
So. So thank you everyone. Okay. So thanks for coming. Bye bye. Bye guys.